Why are you so thirsty?
Why?
Why?
Why? I'm not thirsty. I was thirsty to win.
Super thirsty. I mean, you are super thirsty.
Oh, my God. Why are people saying that?
I don't know, but I have to tell you a quick boring story. It's really boring, but you're stuck here with me. This year I was in the media room. Usually I'm in the audience. I was in the media room with all the press because that's where they put me this year because they can't trust me in the audience. And when you took Paul to the final, everyone panicked.
Yeah.
Everyone gasped. Everyone's like, oh, no, don't do that. Don't do that.
Yeah.
Paul gave a speech. Everyone's like, that's a really good speech. You start answering your questions. People are like, Josh is doing better than I thought. You got to your speech. They're like, Josh is doing better than I thought. Votes started coming out. 4-4. I don't know why I'm replaying this. I'm just a fan. I was there. And that last vote hit. And the room went bananas. Media went bananas.
When I won? Yeah. Oh, my God. That's awesome. I thought people were pissed.
No, it was an awesome finale. I mean, it was. Everyone likes a close game. Yeah. It was down to the wire. It could have gone either way.
Yeah.
But... what did you do? What did you do in the last week that changed this game?
Honestly, my goodbye messages and my speech, I knew I was going to nail it. Paul played a great game, but I couldn't turn on him so late. I gave him my word, and I was going to stick by my word. But he was playing his game. I was playing mine. So, yeah, you don't want people to know the game you've been playing, and I'm protecting that. But I also have a voice. So they're going to know that I've been working with you guys. And the reason why I didn't, why I had to evict Alex and I had to send Ray Vanell is because I stuck by you in Christmas and Paul. So he can be mad about it, but at the same time, I had to play my game.
You earned your money, man.
Yeah.
I mean, you were there just as long as anyone else. So as a fan of the show and as someone who was just enthralled by the experience in this media room, I have to say it was like electric. It was truly electrifying. And this is the 16th season that I've watched Big Brother, but it's the 5th season I've done the Jury Roundtable, and it was my favorite ending I've ever seen.
Really? I can't wait to watch that back.
Oh, you're going to lose your mind.
Ripping our heads apart. I mean, they were all against us. It was literally like they all, this is what I was thinking. She was loved, and she handled every eviction with grace and with love. I was like, I hate you, I hate you, I pulled a you. I was like, I hate all of you, you're all going home. So I knew that I was disliked, but I knew that Paul, I was thinking, oh, he's the vet, and he pissed a lot of people off too. So I was like, I have a better chance with him, and it worked. Yeah.
And whatever you did, it certainly worked. Now, I have to tell you, I'm a super fan of the show myself, and the Pots and Pans is a long tradition at Big Brother because it's season 2, Sue Hawk from Survivor. You were probably like 4 years old.
Okay.
She woke up, so we had the Survivors come in season 2,
oh,
and she brought out these pots and pans, and that was like the first person to ever do it.
Really?
And I know it was annoying for the people this season because it was annoying my season. Are you gonna get a sponsorship with some sort of like, who makes pots and pans?
I have
like,
no idea, but I hope I
William
get it.
Sonoma.
I hope they gotta get it. That would be awesome.
Do you think, I could see this kind of reoccurring trend where every year, you know, the Big Brother, halfway through the show, things get a little slow, people get a little sluggish, next thing you know, middle of the night, ding dong.
I love it.
Josh rolls
back.
In.
Bring me back with pots and pans.
Pots and pans. He's got them all over them. Zingbot. Yeah. And Josh is just smashing them.
That would be dope.
What are you going to do tonight to celebrate?
Oh, drinking. I'm going to grab Paul, Christmas, everybody, and just give me some wine or beer. I need it.
You deserve it. You earned it. And then what are we going to – so that tomorrow drinking too, next week drinking?
Oh,
like just
the whole
full
week I'm celebrating. I don't even – I can't – it hasn't sunk in that I won yet. So, like, once I got a drink, I'll be like, ah!
Now, what part of Miami do you live in?
Homestead.
Oh,
it's
okay.
Like,
oh, I know. I used to live on 67th and Collins.
Oh, okay.
Mount Sinai. What up, Josh? I can tell you firsthand. Sorry, I'm getting used to this. After Big Brother, even as a winner, it's really weird because your brain turns to mush. You're like, am I famous? Am I not?
Yeah.
Are people looking at me because I have a booger or because I'm famous? What are you gonna do to decompress and just? How are you going to be a normal person and go back into society after being isolated for so long?
Yeah, that's hard, but I got family that humbles me real quick. They'll be like, you're a joke. Stop it. Go bang pot somewhere else. So my family's going to keep me grounded and humble. And I'm just me. I'm a kid from Miami, got lucky, went on Big Brother, lived a dream. I won, and now I go back to my life.
It's always great when a super fan wins because it's like that's – if you're a fan at home and you're sitting here and you're like – I could do that. Then do it.
Yeah.
Then do it. Then go right now to CBS.com and apply for the show and get on the show.
That
Josh did
message.
It. I did it.
That was my message. I was like, listen, if you're a huge fan, I tried out 3 times. And the 3rd time's a charm.
I mean, that's a great story. It's I mean, like, it really does take that. Some people get dissuaded or they get discouraged. I mean, there has been many, many people who've won the show who applied multiple years.
Yeah, Dan Giesling. I don't know, I think 4 times or something like that.
Let's ask him, Dan. You're texting me right now telling me how good my interviews are. So text me right now. Are you there, Dan? You're live, right? Text me. Let's see if he'll do it.
So cool.
Dan, I'm right here. Look, Dan, he's asking questions. Oh, he's saying mean stuff. No, I'm just kidding. He's not. So we'll wait for Dan to do that. What other advice do you have for other people wanting to apply in terms of gameplay? And I asked that in the sense that you had very non-traditional gameplay. Like, no one had seen someone so emotional, screaming, crying, freaking out.
Honestly, I think that my gameplay was so underestimated. People didn't know, they underestimated my physical ability, my mental ability, and how much I knew the game. That was my biggest blessing. I kept that under wraps. I wanted people to think, oh, I have him in my back pocket. I have control of Josh, so why go against him? Because if I would have flipped and gone with Cody, the whole house would have gone bananas. You get me? So I underplayed my whole gameplay. People were like, I'm a Het fan. Do you know Dr. Will? I'm like, hell no, I don't know Dr. Will. I'm Dr. Will's biggest fan. Never said it. So you went in as a fan. I stayed quiet, kept my mouth shut, and I just kept playing up the whole, oh, you know, I'm just here to have fun. I'm just here to bang pots and pans, and I'm the crazy kid. Every time I called somebody out, it was intentional. It was to expose their game. I wanted to put a target on them and let them know, listen, this person's shitty. They're working with this guy, draw attention to them. So a lot of people thought I was just emotional and crazy. There was a method to all my madness in the game.
And it played out good.
In terms of the tears, what was that method? Because you cried a lot.
Oh, my God. Honestly, it was just thinking how bad I wanted to win for my family. Like, I'm about to cry right now. I just,
Let him out.
My drive and my strength in the house was just thinking about my parents and me saying, here, like, this is for you. Woo! So now I get that moment, so it's awesome.
You know why this victory is so sweet for some of the fans is at one point, and I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that CBS is going to fire me right now. I'm okay with that. Is at one point, Paul physically put his hand on you, like he smacked you in the face. And as an adult, that bothered me tremendously. You might not even remember. Do you not remember that?
No.
Do you guys know what I'm talking about? At one point, Paul came up to you and he wanted to like calm you down and he gave you like a smack in the face. And if I was your mom, I would have jumped through the screen and I freaked out.
Is this a lie?
No.
No, back me up here. Someone's saying don't say this. I'm not allowed to say this. Look, oh, wait, Dan Giesing. He says four times, tell me Paul. Tell Meatball hi, is what he says.
Dan, I love you, this is awesome. And then I'm like, during the comp, we have Dan Giesing in the back, the funeral director, and I'm like, oh, I don't know who he is. Everybody's like, I'm like, who's that guy? Dan
super Giesing. Fan. We thought Cameron was a super fan.
He played himself.
Josh, you absolutely deserve every single bit of this.
Thank you so much.
Absorb it in. I'm going to hug it out.
Thanks, buddy.
I'll see you in Miami at some point.
Nice.
The pleasure has been all mine. Thank you very much, and enjoy your victory.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.